Hey, it's Eric here. Let's go ahead and talk about the more advanced look techniques in Scratch. So we see here on the left that we have our haystack background, and we have three sprites to choose from. Let's go ahead and use some of the more advanced look techniques, such as the effect. So right here in the middle, we'll see these three blocks, which enable us to change, set, and clear an effect. So right here, the first block is change color effect by 25. So we'll go ahead, drag this, attach it to our event block, and let's talk about this. So change color effect by 25. So we see in the drop-down menu, this color, we actually have a number of different effects, which we'll experiment with more, but for now, let's just choose color. So this will manipulate the color of our sprite by 25. And 25 seems sort of arbitrary, but think of it this way. If we set it to 1, the colors would only change slightly. If we set it to 25, there's going to be some color change. But if we set it to 100, there's going to be a big difference in color. So that's really just the strength. So 20 is a pretty average change in color, something that we'll notice. So if we go ahead and try this, hit the green flag, and actually I'm going to detach these thumbs. So we'll go ahead and try it. And there we go. We see the sprite has changed from this color, which is sort of a red and a brown, to more of a yellowish a green. So again, we can go ahead, say we made this 50. It's going to be more dramatic. And there we go. We see a big shift in color. And if we ever want to set the effect back to 0, we have a set color effect. So there you go. This would set it back to square 1, right? And likewise, we have a clear graphics, which is if you have multiple, right? So if we have a color and one of these other, we can go ahead and clear all of them by doing a clear graphic effects. So I'll go ahead and preview that, and we should see that it's going to get rid of all of those effects. So there we go, back to square one. So let's go ahead and quickly browse through some of these really cool effects that we have. So color, that changes the color. Fisheye, we'll go ahead and preview that. We see it kind of makes them bulge a little bit. So we'll clear that out. So again, clear graphic effects. Twirl, that's going to actually whirl the sprite. So we'll go ahead and do that. Again, you can change the strength. So if we made this like 200, we'll see a dramatic twist, right? Really dramatic. So we'll go ahead and clear that. Pixelate, this is really fun, and we'll see that it sort of gives that sort of like you're on cops a little bit. So we'll go ahead and clear the graphic effect right there, and then we'll jump down to mosaic, and this creates copies. So think of that famous Marilyn Monroe photo. So it's going to create copies of the sprite. This is actually a little tougher to see, so we'll go ahead and hit something like 20 and see if we can't see the mosaic there. So there you go. We see different copies of the sprite. Very cool effect, very artistic. So we'll go ahead and clear this out. Brightness, this is kind of obvious. If we raise it up, the brightness is going to go up. And ghost, this is cool. So it's going to add some transparency. So we can see that it sort of our sprite is now see-through, which is sort of cool. So we can see behind there. But I want to introduce you to something that really takes these effects to the next level, and this is a very sort of advanced technique, and that is all of these are cool by themselves, right? So we now have a sprite that's see-through, but say we want like to make this dynamic, we want the sprite to disappear. So I have here a sound, so I'll go ahead and play my project, and that sort of begs for this like dynamic motion effect, right? So we'll go ahead, and this is when we introduce the loop. So we'll introduce a forever loop. And then we'll go back to our effects. And using the same concept we used earlier, we'll just put this effect in the forever loop. So forever, change the color by 25. Let's try it out. So you see, it's constantly running that effect. So then we get these really cool sort of dynamic effects. And the number then turns into how often the effect will take place. So 25, we see it's a lot of shift in color. So if we did something like 10, we would see, or rather 5, we would see that it'd take a little bit longer for the color to change, right? And if we made it 50, it'd flash really quickly. Cool. And these can be used with any other effects. So color, likewise, we have ghost. So this is gonna affect the transparency. So in theory, it should add the ghost effect constantly by a rate of 10. So we should see our gobo, or our nano disappear. So let's go ahead and try it. So there we go. If that seemed like he disappeared too quick, we'll change it to one. So it slows it down. So these are all like the really cool, once you put your looks, or your effects rather, into a forever loop, it really adds that advanced sort of dynamic feel to it. So definitely think about using forever loops or any other loop for that matter.